caiman are a type of alligator. And this particular type of caiman is one of six varieties. It's called a Yacaré caiman or a Paraguayan caiman. They used to be thought to be spectacled caiman, but now they're their own species. And there are 35 million of them, according to the official count, in the Pantanal. The locals say this is an undercount. Back during the 1980s, around 1 million Yacaré caiman a year were harvested for leather goods for the most part. Now, the population of the Pantanal was maybe only a few million at that time. And the reality is that they've been protected since, and now they're on the rebound. This young caiman is going to demonstrate the high walk for you. As I said before, Yacaré caiman are a type of alligator. There are two true types of alligator. One is in the southeastern part of the United States, and the other one is in China. The difference is their ability to withstand cold temperatures. True alligators dig burrows into the side of the riverbank, and they stay there for cold periods. Caiman, on the other hand, are strictly tropical alligators. They really can't stand the cold. But the males do bellow, like North American alligator do. And this is getting close to the breeding season, and so we heard a little bit of that. These little guys are kind of cute, but you have to be careful. Mom's not terribly far away. And caiman-like alligators can hide very well under the water. This next caiman thinks that he's hidden, but the water is so shallow, you can actually see him. One of the most interesting times to go out looking for caiman is actually at night. Sure, you can't see the animals, but they do give off good eyeshine. And they tend to be rather compact. They're in the water at that time, usually because the water is considerably warmer than the land. There's a lot of bugs in this picture that you can see, but what those lights are in the background is eyeshine from caiman. This is an iguana. Despite its fearsome appearance, it's a vegetarian. It's common throughout South America. It's found just about everywhere. And because it feeds on vegetation, you assume that it's not a very fast runner. This video certainly suggests that it's not very rapid. But in fact, when scared, an iguana can move so fast that its hind legs will pick it up off the ground. It does something of a wheelie. And the front legs simply hang back, not ever touching the ground. We're going to slip up on this iguana until he's frightened and runs. And then I'm going to switch the video into slow motion for you so that you can see what he's actually doing. Thank you. Okay, I did cheat. Lizard that you just saw was a basilisk lizard, not an iguana, although they're closely related and quite similar. The basilisk, however, can run so fast that he can actually run on water. That's also partly because his rear legs are so large. However, the iguana runs very much the same way at very close to the same speed, but he can't run on water.